Hello, in this video, I'm going over resource groups and naming conventions in Azure. Hello, this is Seraltos, I'm Travis. In this video, I'm going to cover resource groups because for a lot of people, the concept is new. Most other Azure services have some sort of on-premise service that's comparable. For example, the concept of IaaS servers is not much different from physical servers. The concept of app services is not far from IaaS or another web platform. Log analytics is similar to any other type of on-site log collection service. Before I go any further though, just a quick reminder to subscribe. Every time someone hits my subscribe button, an angel gets its wings. All right, back to it. Nothing on premises is comparable to a resource group. In Azure, resource groups are used for two main things: organization and billing, and a security boundary for role-based access control. Per Microsoft, a resource group is a container that holds related resources for an Azure solution. Notice it's not intended for holding the same resources, but resources related to an Azure solution. For example, you would not put all storage accounts in one resource group and all app services in another. Instead, you would put all app services, storage accounts related to one solution in a single resource group. Let's consider two projects, Project X and Project Y. Both require multiple Azure services to support the solution, and two different groups will be working on the project. By isolating those services in one Project X resource group and in one Project Y resource group, role-based access control can be applied at the group level, only allowing access to those who need it. If cost recovery is used, billing can be calculated based on the resource group. When the project is over and the resources are no longer in use, simply delete the resource group to remove all the resources. This helps prevent orphaned resources from lingering in your environment. There are no regional or connectivity constraints with resource groups. A resource group in one region can hold resources located in another region, and resource groups will not constrain interaction between those services. For example, two servers in two different resource groups can communicate with each other on a virtual network deployed in a third resource group, providing the supporting configuration is in place. Let me give you an example. My current test subscription has one resource group for all virtual networks. This has a VNet and the subnets and all the other networking I need to support the services. I have an IaaS domain controller running. That, along with all supporting services such as a storage account NIC, are in a different resource group. VMs and other resource groups can communicate with that domain controller, providing they are connected to a subnet on the same VNet. While I'm at it, I'm going to tack on one other subject in this video, the subject of naming conventions. Resource groups are one of the first items you'll set up in Azure, and you'll need to give them a name. You can name most resources just about anything you want, but that doesn't mean you should. I can point out some guidelines for naming conventions, but the most important takeaway is to put some thought into all resource names before you start implementing services. This goes for any services, not just resource groups. Without a good naming convention, resources and service names can become inconsistent, confusing, and make the environment difficult to understand. Microsoft has a good guideline published on the naming conventions. I'll include the link below. I recommend reviewing Microsoft's best practices and coming up with your own naming convention that fits your environment. Names in Azure are difficult to change. You will be happy to get this right out of the gate. If you have any recommendations on names in Azure, please leave them in the comments below for others to consider. I hope you found this helpful. If so, please subscribe, like, and leave a feedback if you're so inclined. Thanks for watching.